Part two. Disclaimer. Everything you hear in this interview is right from the camel's mouth. Anything you've heard on the internet, please be sure to disregard that bullshit. If you heard it on some media site and wasn't straight from the camel's mouth, like I said, please be sure to discard that bullshit. And if you still don't get it after this, be sure to miss me with that.
What does Dark Dynasty mean?
Man, I swear, people ask me that question, and they're expecting this, knowing me, I'm kind of a deep, person, they're expecting this, deep answer. Dark Dynasty, what does it mean? It was really supposed to be Dynasty. It was just supposed to be Dynasty Kennels, right? And, when I wanted to abbreviate it, it was DK. This was Donkey Kong. So I was like, man, it can't be Dynasty, can't be DK, that ain't gonna work. So I needed another letter, so it could be three. And, I just kind of started thinking, and I liked, darker colors. I always wore black, and I liked, kind of castles and that kind of theme, and, call me a nerd. I liked Harry Potter and that look, So, dark kind of just kind of came into it. So I was like, all right, it'll be Dark Dynasty Kennels. And then as time went on and I realized, I didn't even have kennels, until I moved here. Now I have a training kennel, but I still, the majority of the dogs live here with us. I never really had kennels, so it wasn't appropriate for me to call my business that, I'm more trained dogs. So I changed it to Dark Dynasty Canines, a couple of years ago officially, So it's really not much of a story to it. It's pretty simple. It just didn't sound right as Dynasty Kennels or Dynasty Canine. It would have been DK abbreviated, so I needed to be DDK, and then it became DDK9. That's it. Simple.
So, what would your life be like without dogs?
Nothing. I mean, God, why I say nothing, because you say, you have a family and the whole thing. Well, I wouldn't have them if I didn't have dogs. My dogs brought them to me almost. You'd have to know the story of how, my wife and I came together and how different things in my life transpired. But I've always had dogs. There's always been, dogs. I've always had dogs from the moment I got, had my first dog, from when my father passed away and I was allowed to have a dog. It was just a forever bond. I knew from there I'd always have a dog, and then it kind of just grew. It was like, I had one dog, I had two, that was kind of like, you have two dogs, so it's kind of a big transition. Then I got a third dog, so then I had three dogs. So then you have three, and it's kind of like, well, what's four? And it, from there, what's seven? What's it? And it just kind of goes from there, So the family just started growing, and I just, bonded so deeply and fell so deeply in love with a passion of understanding these dogs and wanting to, learn from them and learn with them, and grow with them. So, dogs are everything for me. And again, like I said, people are like, like I said, you got family. People always come with their under comments, try to stuff what you're saying. But, I'm telling you, if I didn't have dogs, I wouldn't have been brought this family. Like I said, man, to my want to learn from these dogs was just so extreme, is so extreme that, life would be nothing without them. I wouldn't know where to be without them. I wouldn't have anything that I have today without them. Dogs gave me a life. They gave me everything that I have. Everything I have, they gave to me. Aside from, obviously, life, And again, my mom ain't back there taking offense to what I'm saying. My mom knows I love her more than anything on planet Earth, and that's not what I'm saying. So I know, like I said, everybody with your damn undercomments. I beat you to it, but I'm just saying, dogs are I cannot even put it words on the importance that they have to my life. I can't put it into words.
So how has it been with the new baby around, baby Jackson?
It's been great. it's been great, here, it's just everyday life, Some people prepare for things like it's a major event. But for us, it's just life, Life just moves on, Life just moves, we just move with it, and a beautiful baby was born and brought into the family. And, we just move along with it, you know, like, as a common question, you know, what's the adjustment been like, this, that, and the third. I mean, there is no adjustment, you know, it's just, this is how we live, you know, we welcome baby into the world as a member of this family and in how we live, you know, same way that Jordan grows up, same way that all the kids I hear grow up, you know, they embrace, you know, everything that's here, you know, everything that they touch, you know, so, I mean, it's been beautiful to have a new member of the family, you know, and I think a big part of it is that, you know, we can share this with you guys, you know, we can now share, you know, how to properly interact, you know, and you know, bring a baby home, you know, and my main thing, too, is, you know, don't make it an event, you know what I mean, don't make it an event, just make it everyday life, you know, dogs just flow, humans just flow, like my favorite person in the world, Bruce Lee, says, just be like water, and, you know, that touches to so all of our training style, you know, adaption is the key to life, you know, so we just live and let live and adapt to everything that's coming, man. So it's been beautiful. We love Jackson, man. Second son. There's nothing like it in the world, man. Love it.
If any, what fear did you have before starting Dark Dynasty K-Dynasty?
Fear nothing, you know. Just to be clear, I don't fear anything. You know, that's that. Fear is non-existent. But, yeah, I mean, for me, it wasn't like, oh, I'm about to do it. You know, I mean, it's just, again, it's like, it's just, you know, success is a mindset, is a vision. You know what I mean? Like, and it's, that sounds so corny. I'm sure you've heard people say that before, but it's really very true. It's all a matter of how you look at it. And to me, I didn't look at it like, all right, all this could happen, that could happen. Like, I'm just like, you know, it's just, let's just try this out, let's just do this, you know, and it just I attached to it, and I fell in love with it, and you know, that was that, and it became constant, and, you know, and it actually became the only almost constant in my life, that as I spiraled through life, you know, as a young adult, and you know, going through different things that a teenager goes through, you know, dogs were always consistent in my life, and that was something that I really recognized at a certain point, was that, you know, what dogs could teach me, the stability that I could learn from them, you know, so, you know, yeah, no, I mean, fear is the wrong word, man, definitely fear is the wrong word, no fear at all, man, we just jump and go.
Why don't you answer all the questions, all the fans' questions, everyone that is asking you questions on a daily basis?
Because it's impossible. I mean, from short answer, it's not possible, you know? Yeah, I mean, that's really it. It's just not possible, you know what I mean? And you know, that was the part that really got difficult when things got big, you know, when it really got extreme, you know, and all my accounts turned just viral constantly, you know, is that you feel this disconnect, you know what I mean, this mild disconnect, you can't constantly be the person that's on there, you know, it becomes different people, and, you know, like, you know, for if this isn't already known, you know, anybody that's on my fan page, that is not me in the messages, you're not talking to me in the messages. I never see them. It's nothing that I ever see. I, you know, there's other people that are on there. A lot of the time, it's me in the comments. I'll comment on different things. But even there, there's different people commenting. You know, so, and even with all of us, it's still not possible. You know what I mean? It's like you can't grasp the numbers of some of these things. It's an impossible thing to grasp. You know, but like I said, that was something that, you know, became, you know, was kind of a downfall of it. But it's something that I've always, you know, said, and I always, everybody that's around, from all the PR people, everything, I've always said, I will always keep control of my social media, I'll never give them up, you know, it'll always be me, I'll always be there, you know, it's in some way, shape, or form, you know, but it's impossible, you know what I mean, to deal with it, you know what I mean, it's impossible, literally, and Instagram people, I've probably had 50 messages answered in Instagram ever, right, it's impossible. It's literally impossible. So the best way to reach us is, you know, the ways that are clearly indicated on our websites, you know, phone number, which I can make pop up right here, so you can reach us here if you want, and you can also reach us right here if you want, email. So that's how you can reach us. So why don't I respond to fans? Because I do respond to fans, and I try to respond to as many people as I can. But it's virtually impossible. And you know, the part of it is, if I respond to one person, you know, like, you want to respond to everybody. Even when I go to liking something, I want to like everything, right? So you go and like something, and you're gonna go like, what are you gonna go like 1,200 comments? You know what I mean? And some it's more mild. You know, some things it's controllable, but some it's just. It's off the wall, and the amount of things that are posted each day, I mean, it's just an impossible task, you know? You can never keep up with it, you know? But I love each and every one of you. Understand that we're there, we're feeling it, you know? Everything, you know, comes to us and circulates, and I love each and every one of you that's out there, even the people hating. I love everybody. I love everybody that's a part of our social media pages, you know? And if I never reply to you, you know, don't be offended by that, you know. And also, when I do pick something to reply to in a video, you know, I like to reply to a question that can have a little bit more of a broad answer. And just for the record, I'm not going to answer training questions like that, you know, because a lot of the time they're too detailed. And, you know, just for liability reasons, I'm not going to speak on things like that, you know, via text or email, or you know, we have classes, and you know, we have different things that are coming up. If you want to learn about how we train, just stay tuned. You know, that kind of stuff won't really ever be answered on camera or in this type of situation. So
why do you charge so much for your puppies?
I don't. Yeah, I mean, like, I don't, you know, that's a, you know, we wanted to the disclaimer. You know, I mean, I don't. Unless you heard it right from the camel's mouth, then it's probably not true. All right,
stop. Stop talking. So before you get on your comments and you say, oh, well, you said the dogs are worth $500,000, let's together listen to what I said closely. Okay, go ahead.
The puppies could potentially be as big as Hulk. If they're all trained as protection dogs, could be worth in excess of $500,000, absolutely.
Huh. Potentially, if they were all trained as protection dogs, they could be worth. You have to pay attention when it comes to media. You really have to pay attention. So anyways, just wanted to stop you before you made your hateful comment on that little part of this video. That's it. Go ahead.
You know, I don't, you know, like, yeah, I sell dogs starting in 2000. You know, I mean, if that's a lot, then I understand. You know, but, you know, compared to you know, XL world and this world, you know, there's people that start their prices higher than me, believe it or not. Yeah. So, you know, do we have a high price point on our dogs that are trained and sold? Absolutely. I mean, talking a year and a half of our time, and lots goes into this, you know. So, and even that, in the realm of protection dogs, my dogs are very cheap, you know. So, my dogs aren't so expensive, you know. And I mean, that's just kind of a myth. You know, I mean, they're affordable to the average person, and they're affordable to very rich people. You know, I mean, it all depends on how you work it out. You know, we also work things out a lot of different ways. If you're the right type of person and you pass all the screening, and we feel like you're the right person to have one of these dogs, I mean, you know, stranger things have happened. You know, I mean, we do lots of things. You know, we do lots of things. You know, we do lots of things from the goodness of our heart, you know, a lot of time as well, you know. So all that stuff is a myth. You know, it's a myth. My dogs are $1,000,000, this and that, you know. I mean, the thing that I'll say is not a myth is I was offered $1,000,000 for Hulk multiple times and I declined it, you know, if that's true. You know, I mean, and we'll get into that later, but why would I take him? You know, he's a family. Why would I ever do that? You know, but there's other sides to it too. But, you know, simple.
So why didn't you take that $1,000,000 for Hope?
I mean, short answer, because he's my son. I mean, that type of thing is never for sale. You know? I mean, that's family for me. I mean, it's like I said, that's like part of the problem for me with these dogs is that, you know, I love them so much and so deeply that it gets in the way of proper business function a lot of the time. You know, so for me, I mean, and the sense too, it's just like, you know, to live in my realm, you know, like, you know, you know, my business and my company is worth way more than $1,000,000, you know, so why would I take that? If you're going to look at it as something I ever was going to do from a business perspective, that would be a terrible business move. I mean, this dog alone, it will and has generated way more than that, So why would I sell something that makes more than that, you know? But the real answer to that, because none of that even matters, is the fact that I'd never sell this dog or any of my core dogs like that because they're family to me. And you can't, like, that's it, man. Like, that's it. No matter what anybody out there wants to think or what story you want to believe, you know, I'm probably one of the only, you know, dog places, because I hate the word kennel, you know, in the world that, you know, my dogs retire here. You know what I mean? Like, that's, they live here till the day of their natural death. You know, they're all here with me, you know, and that's part of the almost a problem. It stops expansion. It stops a lot of things, you know. The dogs constantly take up room, you know. But I have such a big heart that I always let that happen. I can't not. I love them too much. I love them too much. So none of my core dogs are ever for sale. It doesn't matter, man. $1 million don't wow me. So that's that.
Did you ever hang your papers?
Oh, man, I mean, we already talked about this, but I mean, absolutely not, you know, absolutely not. I mean, that's, oh, man, I mean, I mean, what do you even do with that? You know what I mean? Like, what? How do you reply to that? You know, like, did you hang your papers? No, like, it's, rewind, go to part one, it's, come on.
So tell us a little bit about Band Dogs.
Yeah, I mean, it's a common word people like to use, but I mean, better get on Google. That's all I can say about that. Before you use that word next time, get on Google. Okay? A band dog is a description. Alright? It's not a breed of dog. Well, this is all I'm gonna say about that. I mean, it's just like the ignorance of that is ridiculous. But yeah, go ahead with that.
For everybody out there who wants to know, is Hulk a pit bull?
Hell, writing these damn questions, man. Is of course he is. Absolutely, absolutely. By all sense of the word, absolutely. You know, by all documented paperwork, and like I said, like I touched on before, I didn't do anything wrong. I did nothing different than anybody else. So, absolutely. He's nothing different. He's absolutely a pit bull. So Google the word. I don't know what pit bull means. Google it, man. Go Google that, man. Tell me what you see.
How do you keep your business original and stay away from all the trends?
I mean, you know, originator, creator, you know what I mean? Like, leader. I mean, you know, to say original is really kind of a hard thing to pin, you know what I mean? Because, I mean, nothing is really original almost, you know? I mean, yeah, I mean, nothing's original. You know, it's just a matter of finding, you know, finding your niche in something and doing it your way, you know, and making it original from that, from where it's not recognizable from anything other than what you're doing with it, you know? So, I mean, for me, you know, being a creator and understanding, you know, things that I put on the internet and things that I put, you know, out to the world, you know, they can be, you know, taken or copied, and they are all the time, you know. But, you know, that's flattering, you know what I mean? That's a positive thing for me. And for me, I'm a person that enjoys challenge, you know. So anytime I see somebody trying to copy me or do something, I just step my game up, you know what I mean? It just makes me turn up. You know what I mean? That's it. You know, I enjoy a challenge at every single turn. You know what I mean? I'm a competitor with everything I do. It's almost a problem in my life. You know, but I'm very, very competitive. You know, so, you know, I enjoy that. You know, and it's the same way. You know, you drop something that I like, it's fair game. If I see something that I like in it, you know what I mean? I could take it and turn it into something that I use. You know, take it and turn it into, make it my way. You know, and, you know, not to be like that, but I'm going to make it better. And I mean, that's that. And you know, that kind of, you know, confidence, which people, you know, all the time mistake for, you know, an ego, you know, really, that's not about an ego. That's how I keep myself going. That's how I motivate myself to be the best that I can be all the time. So I constantly challenge myself. I constantly know that I can do better. You know, I can be the best at everything that I do, you know, and I always hold tight to that, you know, so to create original, you know, content, if that's the word that we're using, I mean, for me, it's constant. It's just, anything goes. You know what I mean? It's anything goes, you know, and that's how it becomes the way it is. It's for me, I never, like when I, you know, was initially dealing with these dogs, I never just looked at it like, all right, you know, I'm some guy that just breeds these dogs and trains these dogs. I didn't really look at it that simply. I always looked at it in a from a broad perspective, you know, that it was, you know, more so I consider myself like a big organization, like a brand. You know, I was always into, you know, branding and making it much bigger than just the dogs and thinking of it as a more of a you know, like I said, a major organization, you know. So keeping content original, you know, kind of just came along with that. You know, it comes along with, you know, branding and being able to always have an avenue, you know, to go down, you know, to attract, you know, your viewers. You know what I mean? And that, you know, that's what it's all about, you know. So keeping original is constant, you know, trying to stay on top of it, you know. How do I do it? And like I said, it literally stems from the fact that I compete with myself consistently and I always want to do better. You know, I'm literally obsessed with numbers. You know, like I don't even read comments, but I'll look and I'll be like, wow, that one has 35,000 comments. Like I like to see that. I did not have I read any of them? No. You know, but I like to see that. And that's the part of it part of it that keeps me going and motivates me. You know, I just like numbers. I get obsessed. You know what I mean? It's like, that's something that's very true. And you know, I've always said that. You know what I mean? I feel like, you know, talent isn't something that's real. You know what I mean? I literally just become obsessed with everything that I do. You know, and that's the truth, you know? And it's funny that, you know, I mean, I heard, you know, another public figure saying that, and, you know, I've been saying that my whole life. You know what I mean? You talk to anybody around me, I've been saying that my whole life. You know, that you know, I've always felt that the word talent is kind of an insult. You know, that it's hard work, you know? So, you work hard. I work hard to stay original. That's that.
How is it living with all the dogs and such?
Well, I mean, I don't know if it's hard to live with the dogs. I mean, the house is like it's like a zoo. It's like a people farm, you know, for the most part. I mean, it's like what's it, like 6 adults here, you know, 3 kids, you know, and all the dogs, you know, and the way that our dogs live, you know, with us inside, you know, like I mean, loud. Really, how I really need to say it. Loud as fuck. Excuse the scoochy adjective there. That's about all I can say about living here. It is straight up insanity. You know, I have a little sign down there that says tranquility. It's mildly ironic. But if you do want tranquility, all you gotta do is go up to the top of the mountain and you'll be in the most peaceful place you've ever been in your life. So, you know, it has two sides. You know, to leave the smiling, joking part of it. You know, I wouldn't have it any other way. I love to live, you know, with, you know, my family and, you know, my friends. But I don't, like I said earlier, when I say family, I'm talking about everybody, just to be clear. I'm talking about my dogs as well. So I love to live with my family, you know. So that's been the biggest, you know, bonus ever in life, you know, that you can get to that point where you can, you know, do what you love to do with the people that you love, you know. So that part's great. You know, living on a day-to-day basis, I mean, it's extremely loud. It's hectic. It's 24/7. But, you know, like I hear kids screaming right now, yelling. Wouldn't change a thing, you know. Dogs barking. Sure, Ace is going to chime in on the subject in a minute. You know, wouldn't change a thing. Wouldn't change a thing. The zoo. All
right, so how does the team help you get through your daily tasks?
Oh, man. Like we say, man, teamwork makes dream work. So, I mean, team is everything, man. I mean, team is everything. I wouldn't be able to do anything that I do without the people functioning around me, you know. So, team is everything. You know, I mean, whether we pitter-patter, we argue, we go through our things, you know, team is everything, you know. And, you know, for us, it's been a major adjustment, you know. It's like, and we haven't got to that yet, but I mean, what's happened with our lives in the past year, you know, is nothing normal about it at all. So, you know, it's been a major adjustment in terms of, you know, from a business perspective, you know, I mean, this type of a wave, you know, can crush you if you're not ready for it, you know. So, and, you know, to say to a certain extent, we weren't, you know, to a certain degree, you know. So, you know, we had to rebound and you know, stand together and you know, so we still doing it now, you know, obviously every day, you know, but you know, team is everything, you know. Without the team, we don't have anything, you know. I mean, the function of every person is very valuable, you know, it's very valuable, you know. So teamwork makes the dream work, man. Team make the world go round, you know, that's it, you know. And like I said, it's family, you know what I mean? It's the family, you know, the family. If the family functions, you know, we do well. If the family doesn't function, you know, we suffer, which, you know, hey, is a common trend as well. You know, dysfunction amongst family is something that is real, you know, and as we develop these, you know, different things that we're working on, you know, you'll get to see an inside look at what our lives is like and, you know, on a day-to-day basis, more so than what you see already, you know, but the love is all there, man. I love each and every person that's here, you know, with all my heart, so I mean, I wouldn't change a thing. Teamwork makes a dream work, baby. That's it.
Where do you see yourself at in the next 2 years?
In a giant house. Well, I live in a giant house now, but no, in 2 years, I mean, a lot of things will be, you know, established, or really starting to get established, because that's one of the things that I don't think people understand, you know, is the actual time, you know, that it takes for things to grow and establish, you know, so, but one of the major things that's going on in my life now is the construction of our new house, you know, so that's something that I'm trying to, you know, get finalized and, you know, get everything kind of to where I need it, you know, to move it forward when I need it to move forward. You know, but there's a lot of things that are involved, you know, with it. You know, I mean, there's a lot of pieces, you know, it's not simple, you know, so that's one of the things that I'm working on, you know, because that expands everybody's life, you know, but, I mean, in 2 years, man, I mean, I want everybody here to have, you know, reached, you know, the third stage of their goals in life, you know, and then nobody that doesn't talk to me on a daily knows anything about stages of goals. But those that do know, and that's what I want. I want people to be at that third stage of goals, you know, to really be hitting that peak. You know, my team and people around me, you know, that's where I see us in 2 years. You know, with that success that's been envisioned, even more so. You know, and you know, I expect obviously, you know, just from a simple standpoint, you know, what I mean, the TV show will be running, and you know, the books will be released. We'll probably be working on a second or third, fourth book by then. We'll see. Depends on what's going on, you know. And hopefully, you know, we'll just keep growing, keep going. We'll see how things progress. I mean, we have a lot of different business ventures that we're involved in. I mean, I have my hand in basically everything that has to do with dogs. You know, so you know, a lot of these businesses will grow and expand. A lot of them I can't talk about right now. You know. Unfortunately, I'd love to, but, you know, can't. But, you know, I mean, things will be a lot, you know, things will have grown a lot more than what you see right now, because with what we have, with the development that we made, with the things that are on the horizon, with the capabilities that we have now, it has no choice but to be extreme. And it will be, you know, up and up and up. That's all I know.
All right, in simple terms, what was your life like before you started Dark Dynasty?
I mean, if you call it life, I mean, work, you know, the same way, I mean, I guess, you know what I mean, like, but just not for myself, you know, work for somebody else, work with a limit, boring. I mean, what do we mean before I started Dark Dynasty? Do we mean before I labeled the company, or before I had any dogs? I mean,
when did you consider yourself being Dark Dynasty?
I mean, that's how it's weird to think about, man. It's like, when did I consider that it was... I mean, you know, you feel you're successful at different parts in your life all the time. Whether you know, you're accessible to an extreme level, or you're accessible to your max yet, you know, you feel successful. So, I mean, you know, I felt successful, and I felt like things were you know, good and moving in a good direction, probably pretty early on, you know. But, I mean, life before, you know, dogs, or life before, you know, okay, I guess when it started is as soon as you start to make a website and go online and get in forums and that. So life before that, it was less typing, you know, that's for sure. I mean, it's crazy to think about life going back that far, because life back that far, there wasn't even like cell phones, there's nothing. You know what I mean? Like, I was doing things that would have been viral as ever years ago. I mean, I'm riding a bike with six dogs down the street. I used to have people almost crashing their cars. You know, but this is before, like, you know, YouTube's really live, and, you know, there wasn't no people just with iPhones whipping them out, taking videos. That didn't exist at this time, you know? So life was different. You know what I mean? You couldn't just text your friend. You had to call them. You know, remember phone? You had to use that thing, you know? So you had to call them and hope they were home type thing, you know? So, I mean, life was... I mean, I was young, man. I was a kid. I was a teenager. I was young. So life was not important, I guess. I mean, it wasn't, you know, important, but it didn't have a clear direction. You know, I thought I knew what I wanted to do, and then everything kind of just fell into place. And that's how life's supposed to work. You know, you don't plan it. I mean, you know, you have goals. You set places that you want to go, but you know, you don't plan it. You know what I mean? Realistically, I mean, it just kind of came to me. It just kind of happened, you know? So, life before Dark Dynasty K-9s was boring, man. I am Dark Dynasty K-9s.